This is the Wally Show podcast. To hear the live version, check us out each weekday morning through the WayFM app or at our website, wayfm.com/Wally.
The Wally Show podcast is brought to you by Colorado Christian University Online, where Wally teaches and where you can earn a degree online just like Betty Rock. You can learn more at ccu.edu/Wally. This podcast is also brought to you by United Faith Mortgage. Let their direct lender advantage save you time and money. Getting the facts mostly right.
Even Woody and Buzz got under each other's plastic.
Wasn't Woody made out of cloth?
Yeah, I appreciate you, maybe now's not the time.
That's our commitment to you. It's news-ish on The Wally Show.
So the much talked about and highly contested midterm elections could be in danger this year. And not from voter fraud, but actually even people that wanted to fraud the votes could maybe not do it.
Why?
There is a new danger, and I didn't know this was a thing, but apparently we are in a paper shortage.
Oh, my goodness.
yep. There's a paper shortage, and I will give you one guess as to who's to blame.
You.
No. COVID.
Pandemic. Yes, pandemic is still to blame
the
for
culprit.
Everything. This article I was reading was talking about how, didn't know this was coming. Like, how? We've known these elections are going to... We know when they are every year or every 2 years.
Well, I'm kind of surprised that paper is even still needed. You know,
good point.
You would think that it would be more electronic.
Okay, I went and voted the other day. I did early voting. So they walked me over to a voting booth. It's all touchscreen. Boop, 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 boop. Make my votes. But I had to insert a piece of paper. It prints it on the piece of paper. It spits it back out to me. I then walk it over to another official who then runs it through a digital scanner. It scans both sides of it, and then it holds that into a bin. So I guess if they have to do a recount manually, they have the vote like on paper.
That seems super overcomplicated.
Yeah, we like the redundancy in that.
I mean,
but you saw how after the last election, the presidential election, how contested it was, and it seems like every election, or each year, every election, we're getting more and more, we can test things more and more. And so then as I dug deeper into this article, I'm like, how is this possible that they need like literally 30 million pounds of paper for this thing? And one of the county clerks, their plan was, and I quote, "We are all collectively crossing our fingers."
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, good, good. But he said that their big thing is if they have to reprint a ballot, like a series of ballots because of an error or a change, then they won't have enough paper, and that's what they're worried about. But I'm like, that means people are still voting on pieces of paper with the hanging Chad from Florida all those years ago.
Yeah.
I mean, it's crazy. We do so much on iPads now. How we're not doing everything like that?
Well, and the digital age is so much better than it used to be. Like, I don't understand why we aren't using that.
Yeah, theoretically, it should be more protected, honestly.
Really should. You would think that we would update.
Yeah.
We would be in the 21st century.
I am so surprised. The good news is the Commerce Department, though, says that they have priority for paper during this time. So, like, if they put in an order and Amazon puts in an order, the government will win, basically, and get the paper. But Bezos said if it's a problem, if he somehow got it, he would use his small wallet and give out $100 bills so that all 50 million people could vote, and so it's still
we'll,
going to be fine.
We'll write on the pieces of cash.
Yeah, it's still good. Everything's going to be okay.
Words can build you up. Words can break you down. Start a fire in your heart or put it out.
Uplifting Way FM. This is Wally Show. The Wally Show. I'm like, hey, this is Wally.
This is Wally Show.
Yeah,
Wally.
I feel like I'm on
words
a,
hard.
Speaking of words.
I'm tired today. All right, so here's the deal. This is a great song because our words have power and they have the ability to build up or tear down. And we use them both, for both, you know. And I've been guilty of one and, sometimes guilty of doing the other one right. And so the other day I was at McDonald's, okay? And I'm trying to get better about listening to kind of what God puts on my heart, even the things I think might be crazy. And for me, that's like talking to people that I don't know and being that person that edifies them. It's a weird territory for me, okay? Full disclosure. Some people, it's natural. Hey, you're amazing to somebody they don't know. So I'm at this McDonald's, and it's been shut down for a long time, the restaurant portion. And it finally was open. We're like, oh, let's go in there. Like, how sad is that, a commentary on life when you're like, a McDonald's restaurant is open. My day is complete.
That's only what you hear from a five-year-old.
I know, right? And like, is the playground open? And so I go in, and this kid is hustling. And he is like, just has joy, and he's working hard, and I'm watching him be the guy that's standing out there. And he's probably 17 years old. And so it's some, and I noticed it, you know, and I was like, oh, it was really like kind to him when we made our order and stuff. And then I just continued to watch him. I said, you know what? I felt like I was like, all right, dude, like, step out here, say something, you know, like, be, encourage this kid. Mm-hmm. So he comes by, and I held the door for him to go to the play gym thing. And he comes out, and I'm like, dude, I have to tell you. I said, can I stop you for a second? I know you're busy. But, like, there are so many people that don't want to work today. And they, and if they do, they come to work and they got a bad attitude, you know? And I said, you are standing out. You are an amazing employee. Mm-hmm. Like, you're working hard, and I fully respect the way you're doing this. And it took him back. Like, he was like, oh, thank you. I mean, I'm just doing my job. Mm-hmm. I said, but you're doing it well. And that makes a difference in this world. So thank you. I appreciate what you're doing.
And he's very kind.
Yeah. And then so he went on with his day, and then I walked off. And so you never know how that works. But I know there have been people that have encouraged me, and it was the right day, you know? And like, God uses these things. Somebody reached out and was like, hey, I really appreciate what you do. And I had just had a really bad, you know, altercation with someone before that or something. Mm-hmm. And so you just never know. So I'm trying to get better about that in my own life. Not with the people like Betty and Gavin that I know.
I know. I'm still waiting on that.
You're fine.
Me too.
Gavin, you're amazing.
Oh, thank you. My day is made.
So here's what I'm curious about, okay? When did somebody's words matter to you? It could have been a stranger, you know? It could have been someone you hadn't heard from.
Well, like your situation, that was a complete stranger that, you know, encouraged him.
Yeah, and it was weird for me, but I'm glad I followed through with that. I felt better after I did, too, you know? So I'm really curious about that for you. Did somebody's words, their kind words, their encouraging words or something like that, hit you at the right day and they meant a lot, and more than that person probably even knew? 855-33-WAY-FM is the number. We love having you on the show with us. That's how you can get in right now and share your story with us. 855-33-WAY-FM. Have you ever had maybe even a stranger or somebody give you words that meant something to you? Because our words have power.
Absolutely. My mother passed away, and I remember my brothers and my sisters us talking, and we were saying that our mom did not have any enemies. And it was just amazing, you know, the outpour of love that we had at the funeral home. Well, this lady walked in, and she did not like our mother. And we were reminded of that. And I was like, oh, my goodness, why is she here? And me being the oldest, I walked over to her and greeted her. And she said, please forgive me for the way that I treated your mother.
Oh.
And I just felt the Spirit of the Lord say to me, tell her all is forgiven. And to me, that was just amazing that she even showed up. It just really touched our heart.
And it was on you too, because you could have been bent and, you know, and been like a lot of other people. Well, I don't forgive you. My mom's dead and you treated her badly, but you chose the Christian route to say, you know what? It is forgiven. We're good.
Yes, absolutely.
And obviously that shows too that it was weighing heavy on this woman's heart, like the way that she had treated your mom. And so I'm sure that your words of saying everything is forgiven, man, that probably made her live life a little bit more lighter, you know, and a little bit happier.
Yes, I sure hope so. I have not seen her since then, but if I ever do, I would love to tell her how much I appreciated her coming.
Well, Carrie, thanks so much for being on with us and sharing your story.
Yes, thank you. And thank you guys for all you do. I truly enjoy hearing you guys in the morning. You're just amazing.
Well, look at those kind words. See, you just never know what they're going to do. I feel great.
I feel wonderful.
Have you ever had words from like some random stranger that actually meant something to you?
Oh, absolutely. It was an awful, awful day at work. It was just terrible. And I took my lunch break, went to Zaxby's, and I placed my order, went and sat down. And the woman who brought my food out to me, she could just sense it. You could feel God on this woman. Like, she had that presence about her. And she just looked at me, and she was just like, can I pray with you? And
wow.
I didn't tell her about my day. I didn't do anything. I guess I was wearing it, or she could sense it, or God told her. And when she said that, I just lost it. I cried. And she prayed over me. And it was just like this weight lifted off. I mean, I wanted to crawl in that woman's lap and just let her snuggle me all day long.
Oh, wow. That was a rough day, apparently.
Right.
It was a rough day. It was rough.
April, I think what it is that you know, when you're going through a rough day, when most of us are going through a rough day, we kind of feel like we're being forgotten or we're not being seen. And so when that woman took the time and you didn't even tell her how your day was going, it was almost like God being able to say, hey, I see you, I value you, and I love you. And you were able to see that through her. And I think that just goes to show that we can be the hands and feet of Jesus, even with complete strangers.
And it doesn't hurt to do all that with a side of Zach sauce.
Amen.
Oh, yes.
Have you ever had like a complete stranger say something to you when those words mattered?
Yes. So I was working as a referral coordinator in a vocational rehabilitation office. And there was a gentleman in his 50s or so who I had interacted with on the telephone, set his appointment, confirmed, made sure we had his information. And the day that he came in, when he was leaving, he said, I just appreciate that you've been kind, that you've been patient, and you haven't rushed me off the phone. And, you know, I said, you're welcome. And he walked out of the office. But about 2 minutes later, he came back in and he said, I just got to say that you're remarkable.
Aww.
And I started to tear up. I had actually switched that job from one that made me feel like I didn't have a lot to offer, that, you know, I was inadequate in a couple of ways. And so that really meant a lot to me. And even 5 years later now, that word sticks with me. And, you know, certain situations, I'll see someone looking at me when I'm interacting with them, and I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm remarkable. But the funnier thing, he came back a third time after he left the office, and he said, I just have to ask, are you married?
Oh,
no.
Yeah. And I said, yes, very happily, of 17 years.
You really are remarkable.
Yeah.
Holy cow.
I know, right? Well, my husband did marry me after 26 days, so.
You need to teach me your ways.
Yes. Do you offer courses?
Coffee shops, poolside, back porch, picnic table at the park, at your kids' soccer practice. Just about anywhere can be your classroom when you decide to go back to school online at Colorado Christian University.
I know I got my degree online, and I actually did a homework at a campsite. I was sitting around a campfire writing a paper. That is where I did some of my work that weekend. So life doesn't have to stop just because you go back to school to better yourself. You can work towards this future and this goal that you want to accomplish, and it doesn't have to totally consume you or derail your normal life with friends, your family, or what have you.
And you can earn accredited degrees from Colorado Christian without ever setting foot on campus.
So there really shouldn't be an excuse to not going back to school. If it's something you really want to do, you can do it. And all you have to do is go to ccu.edu/Wally to learn more. And the other really important thing is that Colorado Christian is committed to cultivating the mind without compromising the heart. So check it out, ccu.edu/Wally.
Uplifting WayFM.
News can be a little heavy, so we like to do news-ish. Here's Betty.
If you plan to take your kids trick-or-treating this year, you may want to take heed to what lifehacker.com claims are the 7 sins to make the experience bad. So these are the things you don't want to do.
I'm curious how things have changed from when I went trick-or-treating, if they're different or if the same rules apply. So let's go through these, and I'll share with you some of my mom's rules.
Okay. The first one is parents not being serious about safety. So when you think about it, You want your kids to be able to be seen by people that are in their cars and driving down the road.
Yeah.
You don't want your kid to get hit. So they suggest making sure your kid has a glow stick or a flashlight. This way you can see them in the dark.
Yeah, we never had that. You're like, go as a ninja. I'm like, seriously, Mom, I could be hit by a car. Ninja's good for you.
Another one was just to make sure that they can see through their mask.
Yeah.
If they're wearing a mask. I remember back when I was little, I had this Minnie Mouse mask, plastic mask.
I can see that.
And I was wearing glasses as big as my head. And I could never figure out if I should put the glasses on over the mask or under the mask. There was never really a clear answer. And also just make sure that their costumes are where they won't trip on them.
Okay, that makes sense.
A next tip is leaving a kid terrified. There are some people that when you go up to their house, they have all these scary
Yeah.
Skeletons are things that are moving, or you reach into a bowl and a hand comes out, and you don't want to scare kids. You don't want to leave them with emotional scars.
Yeah, no PTSD.
Right.
And as frail as children are these days, you could get that by saying hello.
Well, that's true. But you just want to make the experience fun, so don't scare them.
My mom's rule was we didn't go to any scary houses. Anybody on the route that had like anything scary in the front yard, like a skeleton or something like that, or just an old person, we didn't go to it.
I saw a video once. It went viral a long time ago, but it was this guy, and he dressed up as a scarecrow, and he sat on a rocking chair on his porch, but you couldn't tell. You thought he was a prop.
Yep.
And all of a sudden, he just reaches up and like scares you, and there were so many people just being like, oh!
Well, there was a guy. This made it on America's Funniest Home Videos. So there's this big dude. He scared him, and the big dude punched him in the face and then felt so bad. I have that on my phone. I send that video to my daughter every Halloween. We love it so much.
And last is, this is for those staying with a home. You're handing out candy. Make sure you hand out candy that doesn't have nuts in it. So you don't want to give out, I believe, Snickers for sure. I know there's peanut M&Ms. Don't do that. There's so many kids now with allergies, peanut allergies. So you don't want to give them an allergic reaction.
And kids are just grabbing candy and stuff like that. So you can't even say, like, here's one that doesn't have it and here's one that does.
Yeah. So just make sure. I know that some families, I believe, you can leave out like a blue.
Purple pumpkin, I think.
Oh, I thought it was blue.
I'm not sure, but there's one for allergies. Yeah.
Yeah. And those are allergy-friendly candies.
Yeah. So there you go.
Yeah.
So if you have any Snickers, though, extra, just send them to my mom. My mom loves Snickers like nobody's business.
See, I remember going home after I trick-or-treated. I had like a pound of candy, and my dad would be the first one to rummage through it and pick out all the Snickers and all the Butterfingers. But that was fine by me. I just told him I want all the Reese's. Yeah. Like, the Reese's are mine.
Tube Blossom, these aren't going to be good for you. You just go, you know, you better go to bed. And then Danny Ray's just rifling through your pumpkin.
And he's just drooling with chocolate. Like,
mom did. Yeah, for sure. Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. And recently, somebody that has never traveled with Betty before got to experience a little of her fear on a flight. We had landed, and this person was like, oh, that's what it was. Okay. Betty doesn't like landing. She fears the landings when we travel.
Yeah, given I should probably do more research on it and the fear would go away, but I haven't. I just picture the wheels, or the sticks that are holding the wheels to the bottom of the plane. When it lands, there's so much force, so much weight, so much speed. And gravity's working against us. I could just see those legs just...
You are right that education will help you combat fear, because in her mind, they're popsicle sticks.
Yes.
That two lollipops are on,
right,
you know, and
exactly.
That's how we're landing. But no, and so we landed and she just goes, whew. She makes a little noise.
I just don't like it.
Yeah. Well, my wife actually hates takeoff and landing as well. Mm-hmm. And like, she'll grip my hand and you see her praying those two times, especially on flight. She hates to fly. Never did before, though. That's the weird thing. We traveled all the time when she was younger. And then I think after we had Haley, this fear as an adult became more manifested in her life.
And typically you hear of the fears that you have as a child and you grow out of them as adults, but sometimes it's the complete opposite.
I'm curious if, Betty, you didn't take a lot of plane trips, though, as a kid, did you?
No, I did.
You did? Mm-hmm. I didn't know that. Did you? Were you afraid of flying then?
No.
Yeah, see, that's the crazy thing. So as an adult,
I guess as a child, you just assume, everything's great. In the world, everything is golden and wonderful.
You've never watched a TV show called Great Air Disasters?
Right?
That's the problem.
And after that, I was never the same.
Exactly. All right, 855-33-WAY-FM. So flying is one of Betty's things that she didn't fear as a kid, but now fears as an adult. So I'm really curious what yours is, because there are some things, and you might even know it's fully irrational. I understand that. But you have it now that you did not have before. 855-33-WAY-FM. I'm curious if anyone on the show has, like, your fear. 855-33-WAY-FM. We'll take yours now.
So for you, Mia, what's that fear that you developed as an adult that you didn't have as a kid?
Traveling, and that's not by plane, but by car. Growing up as a kid, I loved to travel. My family, we traveled all the time. We take these long road trips, and I would love to see the 18-wheelers with their lights on the road, and it was just awesome and amazing. And all of a sudden, as an adult, I started having fears of traveling because, and I think it's because I'm aware now as an adult of all the dangers, the possible dangers that are out there. And so as a kid, it's like, we don't have a care in the world. We just want to go see things.
Yeah, when you're a kid and you see the semis, you do the arm thing where you pull down. You want them to do the honk of their horn, you know. Yeah. And as an adult, you're like, I bet that guy's been up for 36 hours straight, you know. All right, Julie, you're up. What is that fear that you did not have as a kid but you have now as an adult?
Zombies.
Wait, seriously? Because, like, as a kid, that's when you think you'd be really afraid of zombies. Why is this?
I don't know. I was okay, and I loved, like, I Am Legend as a kid, and anything that is even remotely zombie-like will give me nightmares now as an adult. And I know they're not real. It's completely irrational, but I am terrified of zombies.
Julie, I kind of get this because I made the mistake of binging a whole season of Walking Dead over the weekend years ago.
Really?
I should have never done it. I would not recommend it to anyone. But I knew I had an issue when I was getting up one morning right after that. It was like a Monday morning early, and it was still dark outside. I had to get to work, and I saw this guy, and he was coming around the corner of our apartment complex, and he had just been done with a run. And I guess he was just winded, and so he was, you know, like slowly coming back
wobbling.
To
wobbling.
Yeah. And I remember thinking in my head, I need to hurry and get in my car because that's a walker. And I knew I had an issue, and I needed to step away.
The poor man was attacked with a frying pan. He's like, I'm just running.
Stop it!
Has that happened to you, Andrea?
Oh, my goodness, yes. So I grew up in Florida, and growing up, we did lots of retreats, you know, as you would in a youth group. But our retreats always seem to include canoeing or tubing down the rivers. And looking back and having kids of my own, I would never consider putting my bum in one of those inner tubes and floating down a river that has snakes and alligators and stuff like that now.
And in Florida, they're everywhere. If there's a body of water in Florida, there's an alligator in it. Mm. Like, I grew up with alligators, and I used to swim in every pond, every lake, didn't think twice about it. But now, like, as an adult, I'll smack the water at the edge before I get in just to see what's laying under there.
I think what I'm finding out is that these adult fears are coming from having too much knowledge. So really, we just need to be dumber.
Yeah, be more ignorant. You're going to have more fun.
Like, I think that's where ignorance is bliss comes from.
Yeah, exactly. Ignorance is bliss. And I'll tell you, the people on this show are blissed.
And now for some good news.
Yeah! Uplifting! Way FM, this year's The Wally Show with some rapid-fire good news stories coming at you because the regular news is a bit of a bummer. That's why we do good news, giddy up. This was a really cool photo, man. There was a guy that went to a basketball game, a little Kentucky basketball there, and he shows up and he's sitting in the stands with his son, and he is just covered from head to toe with coal dust. He's got his coal mining uniform on, like, so he's a coal miner, and he was at work, came up from beneath the ground, wanted to make sure he made the game with his family, and went straight to there. No shower, no. And if you know anything about coal mining, it's a dirty, nasty job.
Mm-hmm.
And so this dude goes straight to the game, and the kid, like, he's with his kid, and his kid's just like, yeah!
Aww.
So this picture kind of goes viral, like people, you know, showing this off. And somebody shared it with the coach of the team, John Calipari. And which is really cool because I guess he has kind of a connection to this because his grandfather worked in the mines. And so he took to Twitter to try to find this guy so that they could offer him like a great experience at one of the next games.
Aww.
And I love that. Like, that's so cool.
Yeah, you don't typically hear of dads going above and beyond, sadly. But to see that this dad is going above and beyond, making sacrifices so that he can make good memories with his kid, that's
absolutely
awesome.
Absolutely. And so it's funny because the coach was saying, you know, I was sent the picture. I never looked at who sent it to me because when I saw the picture, it just hit me between the eyes.
Mm.
And so then, you know, he wanted so badly to find this, you know, family. And so the internet, thank goodness, shows up. Like, the internet gets it right sometimes. And so they find out this guy is a coal miner named Michael McGuire. And they call to tell him, hey, we're going to give you a special night and you can pick any game you want to go to. And it's going to be great. And so the coach talked to the coal miner's wife. And she said, my husband is humble. He's hardworking. This is hard work, but he makes enough money being there so that I don't have to work. He's a great father. He's done this before. And did you know his beard was red, which is interesting because it looks just black.
Wow.
Yeah. And so he's like, what do you mean? It's like that was all coal dust in his beard. So the team offered him tickets and they chose a game coming up against Kansas. I guess that's a good matchup.
It's a fun matchup.
There you go. Okay. So it'll be a fun thing. And the funny thing is the guy, when the coach called his wife and told her all this stuff, the guy didn't even know. Michael didn't even know because he was still underground working again.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Just keeping on with this job.
I know. You got to love
that's
it.
Awesome.
And that's it, man. Hard work and dedication to family. That's the stuff we want to celebrate for sure.
I'll never forget taking my first compassion trip, and we went to Ghana, Africa. When we got there to the site, there was this little girl. She was 6 years old. I later found out her name was Vivian, and she would not let go of my hand. She followed me everywhere I went on that site. And later, I got to meet her family. I met her mother and her siblings, and they all lived in this little mud hut. I mean, it wasn't big at all. And when I looked at Vivian, she had the biggest smile on her face, and she was just happy to be there, just happy to be with us. And it made such an impact in my life that I wanted to sponsor her right then and there. Because of my sponsorship for Vivian through Compassion, I'm able to write letters back and forth with her. I'm now getting updated photos, and now I think she's even taller than me, which is crazy to think. But I'm also able to see how my sponsorship is providing the food, clean water, and other support that she needs and her family needs to live the best life possible. And I can only imagine now with the pandemic, war, and weather disasters, there are so many other families like Vivian's who are dealing with hunger. So maybe you want to make an impact and sponsor your own Vivian. Just click the Compassion banner when you go to WayFM.com.
Uplifting WayFM. If it's trending, streaming, or starring, Betty Rock's got it. Betty Rock's got it. On The Rock Report. Hey, Betty.
Back in the 60s, many American families would gather around the television and watch one of the most popular shows back then, Gilligan's Island.
One of my favorite TV shows as a kid.
My dad still loves it.
Yeah, it was fantastic.
But to me, I'm like, there is a guy on there that he can invent anything.
Yeah.
Even a telephone out of coconuts.
Yeah.
But he can't get a boat off the island?
Nope.
Come
They tried once, and they ended up on another island. That was a weird episode. I'll give you that. But yeah, it's a fascinating show.
I don't know. That's giving it a lot of credit. And while most of us know the song by heart, one guy found out you can actually sing other songs with the tune.
Oh, I'd like to hear this because I love the theme.
Did you know that you can actually sing Amazing Grace with Gilligan's Island?
No, I did not. Here we go.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Oh, that's so good. That is so good. I wish we would do that in church. I know, like, Chris Tomlin just redoes all these hymns all willy-nilly. Like, why can't we do that?
And what about America the Beautiful?
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain.
That's awesome. I want to see if we can do this with other, like, Christian songs. That would be a lot of fun to do.
Give me an example.
Like something from Zach Williams or something like that. Mm. Like, or like a worship song from Bethel would be fun to try to do like that, because it's so opposite. You know, it's like so intense and dramatic, and we got these big swelling choirs and stuff like that.
And a repeat over.
Yeah.
Over and over on the 18th time, you're like, okay, that might be good enough.
Yeah, like Oceans or something like that. That would actually be appropriate too, because it's Gilligan's Island. So I'll see what we can put together this week on that. That's a great one. Well, Lady Rock, thank you. That's going to do it for your Rock Report.
One and done. One and done.
Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. You have a chance to win a prize here with the One and Done game, but you got to have some thick skin, okay? Because this is the way it works. It's very fast paced. I'm going to give you a top 10 list. And your job is to tell me which of two things came in higher on the list. That's all you have to do. Which came in higher. If you do that, you win a prize. But if you fail to do that, I hang up on you with very little pleasantries. It's just, boom, fast-paced, okay? So, you got to be tough.
And just so you know, he doesn't enjoy it.
I hate it. You're right,
You
Rock.
Know, yes, there will be a maniacal laugh that you will hear on the other end, but really, deep down, it really hurts his heart.
You know what? Thank you for seeing the real me inside of me, because I have a tough exterior. But
oh, yeah.
I'm just so tough. I got a creamy.
You're a fragile little flower.
I am.
On the inside.
So thank you. All right, let's set the bar here. Okay, so this is your list. The top lifestyle changes we never follow through with. Okay, so here's the first choice. Exercising more or eating out less? Exercising more or eating out less? Which is the top lifestyle choice that we follow through with, that we don't follow through with?
I would say going to the gym more, wouldn't you, Gavin? I think that's higher on the list than food.
I kind of agree with that, but for me, like, I started going to the gym, but I never stopped eating out.
Yeah.
When I made healthier changes, I actually would lean towards eating out less.
Okay. Oh. I love people that, like, go to the gym now. They're like, oh, yeah, I go to the gym. You know, Gavin's become a gym guy. Yeah, he's become a gym guy. Yeah, I go to the gym. You know what, Gavin? To your credit, you look amazing.
Like,
you've put in the work, and you've stayed consistent, and I respect you. Nicely done.
I'm going to celebrate with a donut after this.
That, absolutely, sir.
He's telling you that because you're wrong. Like, you're wrong on this list.
Oh, yeah, he is wrong.
Right. Okay.
Yeah,
sure,
but,
sure.
Yeah, exercising more. Betty Rock is right. Woo! So that is the number one thing. So now you can have that in your head, and you can balance out all the other things, like where you think they came in on the list in relation to that. Okay, so that one's off the table. But exercising more is the number one lifestyle change we don't follow through with. And so now we're going to give you choices of two, and you tell us which came in higher on the list. One and done. Again, be tough here. 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. If you want to play, we'll play right now.
One and done.
Uplifting WAY-FM. This is the Wally Show. Katie, welcome to One and Done. How tough are you, Katie, emotionally? Scale of 1 to 10.
I would say about an 8.
Okay, good. You're a tough lady, because that's what you're going to need to play this game. I'm going to give you a choice, two choices here. You just have to tell me which came in higher on this top 10 list of lifestyle changes we don't follow through with. And the reason you have to be tough is if you get it wrong, I'm going to hang up on you, okay? And I hate this part of the game. I hate it. But those are the rules.
Okay.
So here we go. Top lifestyle changes we don't follow through with. Is it going to bed earlier or making sure we get enough me time? Which of those two things is higher on this list?
I think it's making sure we get enough me time.
Making sure on me time.
Ooh, I was going to say not getting enough sleep, because I read an article not that long ago that said something like the average American gets maybe 6 hours of sleep, and we need 7 to 8, I believe.
Yeah, so. And Betty Rock has turned sleep into an art form.
Oh, I have.
Yeah,
I mean, I'm great at it.
Good at it. Like, she's like, cats look at her and go, kittens, learn from Betty. This is how we're going to do this. Katie.
Uh-oh.
I am so sorry.
Uh-oh.
Making sure you get enough me time was the number 10 answer.
Uh-oh.
Going to bed earlier, number 2.
Oh!
I'm so sorry. Okay. And you seem so kind. And now I have to hang up on you, and I hate every second of this. Is there anything you'd like to say on your way out? It doesn't matter. Sorry. Again, I hate this part of the game.
Then stop laughing.
I can't help it. All right, we got time for a couple more one and dones here on The Wally Show.
One and done.
Uplifting WAY-FM, this is The Wally Show. Melissa, you're the next victim / contestant on One and Done, the fast-paced game where you get one chance to win, and if you get it wrong, I'm going to hang up on you quickly, okay? Are you good with those rules?
Yes, sir.
All right, so here we go, Melissa. The top lifestyle changes we never follow through with. You're trying to guess the answer that's higher on this top 10 list. Eating less sugar or being better about recycling?
I think eating less sugar.
Eating less sugar.
I would agree with that. I think when you look at what products or what foods have sugar, you're shocked. Like, I found out bread can actually turn into sugar in your system. Like, if you want to cut out sugar, you're pretty much just going to eat vegetables for the rest of your life. And I think that's hard to stick to.
Well, both of you are absolutely right. That was the number 4 answer. Apparently people don't care about recycling as much. It was number 9. Like, recycle, don't recycle, don't care. Well, Melissa, the good news is I don't have to hang up on you. You just need to hang on so we can give you a prize.
Yay, thank you.
All right, Sophia, you're the last contestant. And here we go, trying to get the higher answer on this top 10 list of things we never follow through with. Hitting 10,000 steps a day, that's been a big thing lately. Or using your cell phone less, which do you think came in higher?
The steps.
Yeah, because a lot of people are like counting their steps on their phone. My wife has like a pedometer she was using for a while. Now she uses her Apple Watch. And so it's a big deal.
I don't know. I think a lot of people find themselves addicted to their phones. And I think we want to pull away from it, but it's really hard to stick to.
Gavin does steps every day.
I do. And my feet normally do hurt at the end of the day. And what helps it is looking at my phone for another 2 hours on TikTok.
Gavin needs to cut out both things. But here we go. Good news, Sophia. Hitting 10,000 steps a day came in higher of one of the things we do not follow through with. Yeah, because we're not putting our phones down, let's be honest. I mean, if you could get your 10,000 steps while on your phone, then maybe you got something there. But the good news is, Sophia, speaking of got something there, you're a winner and you're getting a prize.
Woo! Woo! Say yay! No! Sorry, grandson.
Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show, and we have a prayer wall. And you might not even go, oh, what is that? It's just part of the ministry where if you want to go to wayfm.com, if you text the word pray to 91979, we will send you a link. And it's where you can post prayer requests of what's going on in your life. And sometimes people like to do things anonymously, sometimes people use their name, but it's a place where people can go and look for help and comfort and peace and know that people are praying for them. I mean, I know so many times in Bible study, every small group, what can we pray for you for, you know? And so this is a version of that where sometimes you don't have to share everything with people in your lives, and maybe you don't have a ton of people in your lives. This is a great place to go and all of a sudden have instant people praying for you, and you'll even get a notification when people do. And I think that's the best part of the prayer wall personally. I think that's awesome. And so we like to look through things that are happening there and highlight some things that maybe you resonate with and go, oh, maybe I'll go pray for that one or post one myself.
And that's exactly what Lisa did. She went to the prayer wall and she put up her own request saying, my daughter and son-in-law are having some marriage issues. My daughter is making some really bad decisions. My prayer is that the person who is trying to break up their marriage will sever contact with my daughter. Man, that's a heavy prayer request. And it might be something that she doesn't feel comfortable with sharing with her church. But that's what I love about the prayer wall is you can still find people that will pray for you and lift you up through the prayer wall. You may never know these people, but like Wally was saying, when someone sees that request, they can hit a little box that says, hey, I prayed for this. And then Lisa will get a notification on her phone or through her email saying, hey, somebody prayed for you. And that might be just the thing she needs to see, read, hear if she's facing something difficult.
And the reality is we have a lot of similar shared experiences.
Yes.
The context of some things is different, but I guarantee you there's somebody that's on the prayer wall that has been through something similar to that or know someone that is and can relate to that and really pray for them and lift them up. And so we'd love to have you get involved with this, whether you need prayer or whether you'd like to just go there and pray for people. I think that's really important too. And so you can just text the word pray to 91979 and we will send you a link. Being the parent of like a little kid, I think has gotten a lot harder than when I was raising my daughter. She's 23 now, and man, I got to tell you, the decisions you have to make and the things you have to monitor and protect your children from today has gotten a lot harder. What do you give them that's still entertaining, but also aligns with your values? You know, we've talked about Way FM being a product that you don't have to filter, but like if you got Netflix in your house, you got to have the filter on.
And even Disney Plus, you have the same problem.
Oh, well, I'll tell you, Disney Plus has been disappointing to me as a parent. And some of the things they've chose to put on there. And like, you got to watch it, you know? And that's why it's so nice to have something. If I was raising little kids, I would do PureFlix subscription, man, because you've got content on there that you're not having to filter out. And as a parent, I mean, I know we want to be involved in our kids' lives, but sometimes you need to park them in front of the TV and take 10 minutes to yourself. That's why PureFlix is a great option for families. You got family stuff, obviously. They're even dabbling in some drama. Yes. And PureFlix originals. Like, I saw the movie on their Strong Fathers, Strong Daughters, and I have to tell you,
you cried.
I did. There was three times. Not once, three times.
I did.
I wept, and I was moved, and it was a great movie. And I think if I was raising my child now, I think PureFlix would be definitely a part of my family's entertainment plan.
So if you'd like to try PureFlix, text PURE, that's P-U-R-E, to 91979 to get your 1 week free trial. Faith and Family Entertainment with no ads on your favorite devices. Oh, I hate goodbyes, but there's still more fun to be found through our YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. Just search Wally Show. Don't forget to join our exclusive Potty Facebook group. You can find the link in the description of this podcast. And thanks to Colorado Christian University Online and United Faith Mortgage for supporting what we do.